This is the Space Jockey, an absolute cultural icon from the 70s, and then again with the release of Prometheus. This replica was sculpted from 150 pounds of clay and then molded to produce a lightweight hollow casting. The kit casting in this tutorial video consists of the helmet shell and two eye lens blanks. The first thing I did was trim the casting of any air bubbles and surface flaws by using a Dremel. Then the seam line was addressed with sandpaper and fillers. Power tools can be used to speed up this process. Once trimmed, the seamline areas will be void of some of the surface texture. Re-establish this texture by using a fine-tipped Dremel bit to push in some skin pores. Once you are satisfied, primer the surface and you're ready to install the lenses. The lenses are clear PETG. They are first painted gloss black from the interior, then trimmed to fit the sockets, and superglued in place. To represent the undecayed version, use an airbrush and dark grays and blacks to reinforce shadows and ridges, and voila, you're done. But this was way too easy. Let's build the decayed version. There are several different approaches you can take to texturizing the helmet shell. If you analyze the surface of the film-used prop, you'll see that it has a gooey, torn, flaky sort of appearance. More than can be achieved alone with paint, and much more detail than can be applied with layering a thick paste. Instead, I'm going to show you how to skin the surface organically using an acrylic medium. This medium is called Sculptor Coat. I've used it in the past to create creatures. This time, we're using it to create flat sheets that will be dried, peeled, and then stretched over the surface of the Space Jockey, creating a ripped, organic, fossilized, skin-like texture. A hot air gun is used to loosen the sheets so they can be pulled and stretched. Use more Sculptor Coat to adhere the sheets onto the surface, and then spray it with sealer or adhesive to lock it in place. Be sure to stipple on some extra texture as you go. Sculptor Coat dries fairly quickly, over a few hours, but you can speed the process by heating it up with a hot air gun. Seal it all with clear sealer, and you're ready to begin painting. Begin painting by base coating the entire helmet in antique white or bone white. The airbrush colors you'll need are white, yellow, medium brown, and black. Use an airbrush to shade the model, first using a medium brown, then a yellow brown, then a dark brown. Switch colors often and layer back and forth to achieve color depth. Hit those recessed areas with very dark brown, almost but not quite black. You want to avoid black, or you'll end up with a paint job that looks too airbrushed, too artificial. To step away from that artificial, airbrushy look, I also teach my students to use wash coats to enhance an organic feeling. So put your airbrush away, and let's get to work. Continue this on all the surfaces. Your airbrushed effects are only enhanced in this process, making them look much more blended and natural. Seal the helmet with the clear coat, and we can move on to the final stages. To give the helmet a look of translucency, dry brush a little white mixed with yellow. Keep this final layer very transparent, barely visible. This will give the model just a little highlight push to make it look even more realistic and chilling. The lenses I painted and trimmed earlier in this tutorial need to be weathered now. Start hacking them up with a Dremel. Be sure not to cut all the way through the perimeter at the base. Heat them up to melt the edges a little to achieve this creepy effect. And then you can glue them in place. So that takes care of the fossilized, decayed space jockey helmet. I hope I was able to teach you some techniques to help you on your next project.